She's one of the greatest bowlers ever with over 20 PWBA titles. In 2001, she had a year like no other, winning 7 titles. Can CDB recapture that past glory with a championship at the PWBA Rochester Open? Find out next. And we welcome you to the PWBA Rochester Open Finals. A fantastic field of 4 for 3 games up the stepladder final, the $10,000 first prize. And hello again, everyone. I'm Dave Lamont. Kim Adler will join me in a moment. You've got a wide variety of experience here, starting, of course, with Carolyn Doran Ballard and Josie Earnest in the first match. CDB looking for her first title in a long time. Josie's also looking for her first PWBA title. Clara Guerrero, who's already won this summer, is the number 2 qualifier, and Shannon O'Keefe ran away with qualifying. It's been a summer of Shannon, without any question, on the PWBA Tour so far. And Kim joins me now. First, we talk a little bit about Shannon O'Keefe and her summer and the way she dominated.
She has had a tremendous week this week. She has averaged 226, which is 7 pins higher per game than qualifier Clara Guerrero in second position.
Now, CDB, you know her. You've competed against her. We all know her as a bowler. And this is an emotional experience for her, isn't it?
She had emotions. Going into the stepladder final, she needed the final strike in the 10th frame to qualify for the TV show against Shannon Pluhowski, and she got it. She was quite tearful, and she's taking these moments very precious these days for her, and it's very important. This tournament is a big deal for her because she needs to finish high to qualify for the Players' Championship.
So we'll see how this goes, but she's got a very talented opponent waiting for her in Josie Earnest, and we'll show you that. Our opening of 3 matches coming up for the 2016 PWBA Rochester Open Finals. Coming up. Let us begin. Josie Earnest on your right. Carolyn Doran Ballard seated. So Josie will start. The number 3 seed looking for her first title.
First title, first show. Have to see how those nerves are going to be for her.
She was the number 5 seed in the 2012 Queens. Liz Johnson beat her that year in the opening match. She has a late snap hook into the face, but she ends up with a makeable 6-10.
She's really trying to control her ball speed right now. That was what the players were focused in practice, was whether how slow or how fast they should go, because the condition is still trying to transition and break down at this point.
Josie works at Vanderbilt as an assistant bowling coach there. She was a fabulous player for the Commodores. National champion in 2007, she was player of the year, as well as the first team All-American while a Commodore. And a shot. Yeah, man.
Everyone wants to set a good tone to start their first game like that, and that's unfortunate.
Looking at a Hall of Famer right there, and Carolyn Doran Ballard.
She is looking very focused today. She is wanting to do a lot of things with this tournament today.
And through the nose, and the split that Josie broke up is what Carolyn is left with.
And her speed was on the slower side there. I think she, as opposed to Josie, is intentionally trying to throw it a little slower. Certainly her heart rate's fast, but she knows how to control her emotions.
Take a shot at it. Leaves one behind. So we're going to take a moment to show our USBC a Future for the Sport lane pattern.
Well, this week it was 37 feet, but it certainly played really far out to the right. Most of the players were playing at a spot on the lane about the 8th board, and they were trying to keep it right at that. So that's what she'll hopefully be trying to do today.
Had an interesting chat with Carolyn before the event, and about her, you mentioned her focus, but it's not what it was. She said, I really want to have fun. I don't feel like my whole life is wrapped up in this as it once was. So I want to enjoy it. Yes, of course I want to win. I mean, we know who we're talking to here. But, you know, if this doesn't work out for her, it's not going to devastate her.
She's been through this position so much, and I think having children has something to do with that, too. I think it just recenters your life on different things as being important. And there's a fullness to Carolyn's life now that before it was a lot more bowling. Josie's ball placement straight into her swing there, and that's an excellent shot.
So we'll take a look at Josie's form. A nice shot. I think Carolyn said something to her and got a smile out of her.
She seems pretty loose now. She's a four-step player, and it goes straight into her swing. Large second step, but nice high backswing. You see all the girls out here are doing that these days. And the acceleration through the swing is the important piece, and that's what really gets her to the show this week. She's much further left on that shot. I don't know if that was intentional, but it was closer to the second arrow through the front part of the lane.
Well, let's take a look exactly, and the video will back you up, I'm sure.
So I think she's trying to get from like 7 out to 5, and that time it was definitely 10, 11 on that shot. Never really had a chance through the front part of the lane. But it's one pin to shoot at, so that's the helpful thing. She's using her plastic ball around the fifth arrow.
No trouble at all. Her match play record for this event was 3-3. Her match play average is a shade under 209. Carolyn actually went 2-4 in match play, but averaged almost 218.
That never hurts, getting those scores, especially in high scoring patterns. She got a little fast with her feet there, but she knows how to recover from those shots.
She buried it. Well, let's go back to 2001 for a moment. One of the greatest runs in PWA history when she started the year with a win of the WIBC Queens and followed it up with 6 more titles on her way to becoming Player of the Year.
And I'm happy to say, and also a little confused, that I was there for that. I was one of the competitors to experience the Carolyn Rath that week or that year.
20 championships in her career, 3 major championships. Also wins in the Women's Series Showdown, Women's Series Cheetah Championship. She doesn't like that one. And with good reason.
At least broke it up, which is good. Carolyn likes to shoot at her spares from the left side, typically with a plastic ball. She did not like that off her hand. She was, it just kind of moved through the bottom part of her swing, her hand did, and it really made her rotate a lot more than she really wants to rotate the ball.
What's remarkable, though, and we've talked about these PBA Women's Series titles, but just a title, the last one was 2003.
I know, she's really, it's hard to believe she's without a title in the new inception of the PWBA.
That was the Greater Cincinnati Open. She beat Liz Johnson. Hey, Liz was in the final. Boy, that never happens. But Carolyn's also has made Queen shows. She's made U.S. Open shows. But her last major championship in Sunrise, Florida, west of Fort Lauderdale, was the USBC Queens in 2001 at the old Don Carter Sawgrass Lanes, which sadly was ruined by Hurricane Wilma. That was a great house.
Hurricane Wilma.
Yep. Josie Ernest snaps that in the pocket of the messenger, knocked, and it wasn't answered.
Kiss the pin. It was, look at this, the 6 pin almost tries to get that 10 pin. Look at it. I'm going to knock on your door. Not opening.
Yeah, sometimes I don't open, but that's because I look through the peephole and see who's there. For Josie, this is her first TV show since the Queens 2012, her first on this renewed PWBA tour. And we talked to her about being on television again.
It's going to be exciting, and you know, you always want to go out and win, and that's the ultimate goal. But I also just want to enjoy myself, because you never know how many opportunities you're going to have to be in that situation. And I'm bowling on a great telecast. You know, my first match is against Carolyn, a Hall of Famer, and that's, you know, can be intimidating. It can be exciting. You know, kind of everything wrapped into one. So, you know, I'm ultimately just really excited and thrilled to make a show this summer.
That's a good shot.
She said it too.
A little bit too, yes.
Yeah. She said it, you said it, and the pins spoke as well. So a clean, beautiful strike for Josie there, and a very even match here through the first 4.5.
Carolyn has worked very hard this year on, she believes some of the things that have been working for other girls, keeping her hands soft at the release, extending through the ball better, getting better leverage. Those are all things she's been working on since she worked at Kegel Training Center earlier this year.
That push right through.
So here we have Carolyn, of course, classic style, five steps. She places the ball nice and in time, not as high a backswing as some of the other girls, but she's actually been working on that. And she's trying to keep her head more solid, which she's been doing, and a perfect execution there.
Clara Guerrero awaits the winner of this match. Clara's picked up a title this year. The Players, that was a big one. Gave her 25,000 points. That's got to hurry.
That's right.
And she leaves a bucket behind.
She definitely got that ball further right on that shot. Let's see how far right compared to the other shots. She was playing closer to the second arrow. This time, the ball went almost right over the first arrow. She's trying to, you can see by her body motion that she's actually her shoulder. She's trying to ease it in after the ball's gone. Not an easy spare on this.
Just drive it into the pocket.
Just try.
Yes, well, I didn't say it's that easy. But
Yeah.
Chopped it off, and so a open frame by Carolyn Doran Ballard is put here on the dark side. Josie Earnest has a 3-pin lead as we step aside. So let's take a look at our road to the Smithfield Tour Championship. Liz Johnson, if you see an X, they're in already. So Liz Johnson, Danielle McEwen running 1 and 2, Clara Guerrero, Rocio Restrepo, Shannon O'Keefe. Shannon Pluhowski has got great numbers for points, still looking for a win. Kelly Kulick, same thing. Now, Sherry Tan in 32nd place does have a win, so she doesn't have to finish in the top 16. You see, Carolyn is in 13th. But big points here, you're looking at 12,000 in her bank if she is able to get this victory.
Everybody tries to get to the Players' Championship.
And you are invited only. That is a closed party.
Yes, I can come and watch.
Good shot.
You're right. Additional commentary by Josie Earnest, who joined our broadcast
That's
team for
right.
that.
Some easy work.
Josie had an outstanding Lee Evans Tournament of the Americas in South Florida. I had a chance to watch some of that in July. And 4 gold medals, singles, doubles, mixed team in all events, and a silver in mixed doubles. She has had great success in that event during her career. And that was some great action between the U.S., Canada, and Puerto Rico in particular.
And Team USA, she's with Team USA. She actually said before this Rochester tournament, she had gone to Team USA camp to try and improve a few things, and it definitely helped with this Rochester
Pretty
event.
Good.
Yes.
Boy, on fire right now,
Big
is Josie
Earnest. Big double for her.
Yep, and coming out of the break with that double, which is difficult to do.
She really accelerated through this shot. She's getting very comfortable there. Her ball's just right at the marker, down lane, perfect spot.
So Carolyn, who chopped the bucket in the sixth, is back on the right-hand lane where she has struck twice.
Carolyn is feeling, I heard her break. Her good shot there, lucky shot. But she feels like she's kind of got a rhythm now, and she may have gotten one a little bit slower, but now her speed is back up. Let's watch from down below. Look how close she is to her ankle, and that's another key piece. You'll see all the touring players with the ball in the leverage position right next to the ankle. Very important for strikes.
You're a bowling fan. You may not even know her full name. You just know her by the initials, CDB.
Good shot there.
A little snappy at the very end, and she winds up with a 4-pin.
They may be starting to transition a little bit. You know, we've noticed with a lot of these weeks, the lanes really, the oil moves around quite a bit, and that may be what's beginning to happen here.
You can see her say trip it, and she did get a break.
Never any doubt there. Caroline is such a great spare shooter, and that's part of the reason of her longevity.
So Josie Earnest working on a three-bagger.
Big shot here for her. Big breaths.
Hook a bunch.
Well, that's a washout. I shouldn't chuckle, but the hook a bunch made me laugh. But then the result isn't funny.
Yeah, she got around that ball, and that's what we really try to stay away from out here. We can see it here on the low shot, how much more rotation she got compared to some of her other shots, and that really makes the ball skid where there's oil and hook when it's dry.
What's the strategy here?
Actually, this is not a difficult spare if you're shooting it from the left side, which is what Josie is doing right now.
Kick. Now, the idea, I guess, is drive that head pin over, and instead it chops. So a big switch. And all of a sudden, she had an over 20-pin advantage. It's been chopped down to just two.
You can't give Caroline that type of opportunity. She'll take advantage of it with her experience. She's just trying to compose herself now, get some good deep breaths under her.
Her max 207, CDB at 205. Oh, and a wraparound on the 10. That's a bad break.
Yeah, it was a good shot. She did say it. A little more rotation again, but that's maybe what she's trying to do at this point. And the pin, that 6-pin, goes straight around the 10. You always go, oh, you're sitting there at the falling, just rooting it on. But again, it's not 5, and it's 1 pin, and she will hopefully make this spare.
And she covered it smoothly. Well, now here's a big shot for CDB in the foundation frame. And all of a sudden, she's not only back in a match, in a pretty good position here. If she punches out, she will win it.
The one strike at a time is the important key here, especially this 9th frame strike. Very important. Kind of hung up on her thumb.
And she cannot get the trip on the 7. And she went, ugh, as soon as she threw it.
Grabbed it. Got really late. Yeah, her feet got a little fast on that one. And that's what made her say, I was a little late.
I grabbed it to something
releasing
else.
Releasing off her hand. Yes.
Gonna go for it. Gonna go for it.
Look how close this is. Oh, it just barely, if she had just gotten it a little further right, she would have had that spare. She's not out of this. She needs at least the 2 for sure to put some pressure on Josie.
Got to force Josie to mark in that 10th and put a little bit of heat on her, so we'll see how Caroline can recover. The winner will play Clara Guerrero. Shannon O'Keefe, the top seed.
Better shot.
And missed, and then never took that left turn that she desperately needed it to do.
It just, it looks like the lanes are starting to transition. It wasn't that bad a shot, and it just never turned. It was like 4-3 boards right at that last marker, which is not where she wanted it.
And she missed it. Well, my advice for Josie Earnest is don't foul.
That's true.
And that's pretty much all that's going to take for Josie to advance to the next match against Clara Guerrero. Caroline will pick up some nice points, though, to certainly help her. She's in the top 15.
We definitely have some tournaments left. Now Josie's using the same ball right now.
But I like it when you go out in style and you win
yes.
your game with a nice shot, and that's what Josie Earnest has done. So Josie's moving a step closer to her first PWBA title, but she's got a player who's having a spectacular year, Clara Guerrero, waiting on her next. There is Mike Slins, and he is the Director of League Development for Bullmore AMF. Are you looking for some great PWBA gear? Then visit the official online store of the PWBA at shoppwba.com. There is Josie Earnest. Clara Guerrero, who's seated, is the higher seed. She said, Josie, you get to start. I'm going to watch.
It's an interesting tactic.
How so?
Well, because you want usually the lesser experienced player to finish if you can, because it's a little more nerve-wracking.
Didn't seem to bother Josie at all. Clara Guerrero now. She's had a very nice summer. This is her third championship round appearance. She picked up her first career PWBA title and her first major at the Go Bowling PWBA Players Championship, beat Liz Johnson. And she was a runner-up at the Pepsi PWBA Lincoln Open, and we might have a rematch of that because Shannon O'Keefe is the top seed and awaits the winner.
And she's never dropped below second place during qualifying a match play for this event.
The nose can't get a break. Clara, by the way, is somebody we need to listen to on the mic from time to time.
We may listen, but we may not understand.
Well, 19 years as a member of Team Columbia, so her international experience is extensive and successful.
I just find it hard to believe that she's 34 years old. She looks like she's in her mid-20s. Have all that experience behind her.
And a college at Wichita State. Gonna go for it.
I think a little shake those nerves out, regroup. She's a lot. I think she's quite a bit further left than she had thought she might be for the television show, because really she was trying to keep the ball right of the second arrow pretty much the entire week.
Well, she made a little equipment adjustment right there, bringing out a. It looks like something that you would wear if you were trying not to get hit by a pitch.
And you may see two different balls, one ball on each lane. I have to see how that plays out.
Hook.
Hook it does. By the way, any player who bowls a 300 game on our CBS Sports Network Finals will receive a $10,000 bonus from the PWBA.
You are quite positive. We're only in the first frame going into the second.
I try to look. I see, I don't take it one shot at a time. I'm not competing, so I can be Mr. Look Ahead. I can look back. I have the, you know, that's one of the benefits of this chair.
Well, hopefully we don't jinx her.
A lot. It did. In fact, she almost got a stone nine out of that, and instead gets a powerful strike.
And if she can keep her speed up with that kind of look on that lane, that might be the way to go.
She's kind of fighting a smile a little bit there,
yeah.
Like, I don't want to enjoy this. I'm not supposed to be enjoying this right now.
Holding the excitement in. A lot of rotation there.
Brooklyn that time, and she leaves the sixth pin.
Well, we can compare that to other shots, and it was a good three or four boards left. Let's take a look at where it ends up at the arrows. It's just left of the second arrow, so she's definitely a lot further left on that shot. That was really unintentional.
Question about that single pin for Josie.
Well, let's see what Clara can do here. She looks like she's using the same ball she used on the left lane, now on the right lane.
2009, she was Columbia's Athlete of the Year.
She still bowls for Team Columbia. In fact, she is not. She's one of the players that, after the end of this PWBR swing, kind of hung up on her thumb.
Got away with it in a way. That could have been a disaster.
She is actually returning to compete internationally immediately following the end of the year. Doesn't take any time off. We're going to look at the shot here and see if we can see where she hung up. And it here, right there, is where she should release it. And just very delayed. Good extension through it just to kind of keep up with it. But
you had an interesting conversation with her that I eavesdropped on about that knee tape that she wears. That it's almost more of a security blanket, right?
Yeah, she's just been really careful this year. She's remained good at working out. And her legs have been strong. But that just provides a little extra support, and it's more, if it's an emotional key, then that's fine. That helps her with her bowling, but she's not injured. And one of her goals for next year already is to find a way to work out on a more routine basis while you're out here on tour, which is difficult with the formats that we have. Call that the golf waggle.
Straight through. What a beautiful shot for Clara. 10 straight back. So right back to Josie Earnest, who does have the early advantage here since Guerrero may had an open frame.
Now, one of Josie's self-proclaimed weaknesses is she feels she doesn't see the ball motion early in the front part of the lane as well. She's more experienced seeing it on the back. Her Rob Kochall, who helps her with Columbia balls, and Hammer has been helping her with that.
Now, this was from the first match when she defeated CDB.
Now, we're right here. We're going from the second, right around the 11 board. And we're going to compare the two. And we are just a pinch further left of that. So like a board or so left of where she was to start.
That resulted in a strike in this game. Three strikes and four frames so far for Earnest.
Good acceleration for that shot.
She got a break, kicked away trouble, and has just a single pin to make.
She accelerated, but what I call that is she kind of hit the ball or really accelerated on the upswing, actually, instead of on the downswing. So that created what we just saw with the overreaction in the back part of the lane.
No trouble. Josie Earnest clean through five. And Guerrero on the lane where she opened with an open and then went nine spares as she's seeking her first strike. On this right lane.
The tricky right lane.
Did hook and she got a break. Yes, sir, she got a break. Her first strike on that right lane.
Well, she really did a good job of keeping this ball in line. Really good shot, aggressive. She's a very aggressive bowler. And I believe it really, the ball talks to the pins when you're that aggressive. And she's into it. All the Colombian team, Rocio,
yes.
Clara, they're very intense.
Come on. Yeah.
So a double for Clara Guerrero. We have a match. The winner of this will play Shannon O'Keefe for the championship of the PWBA Rochester Open, and it's a classic right now. Josie Earnest and Clara Guerrero, just one pin separate the two. For the PWBA Rochester Open, 85 entries. If you wanted to cash a check, you had to be good. Almost 206 to do it. To make match play, you had to average 214. Other finishers, Shannon Pluhowski was defeated by CDB in the final frame, Liz Johnson. Rochester kind of close to her area. Daniel McEwen, Jennifer Higgins doing well there. Christina Zerbinski, a left-hander. Diana Zavialova and Brianna Cote. Brianna Cote, a champion on the PWBA this summer, winning the PWBA Lexington Open for her first title, putting her in the Smithfield PWBA Tour Championship. And that's where Josie Earnest would like to go.
So I was just going to say that's something that Josie really is striving towards here.
And in order to do it, to lock up a spot, a win here.
Nice little swing there.
Yes.
Well, these two now have gone from jabs to full-out haymakers.
So here from below, you really see how that ball came off her hand nicely. A good amount of tilt and rotation for Josie. Important piece there is to keep the ball speed up. Her roommate is sitting right behind her, off to the side there.
That would be Erin McCarthy. Talk about great players.
Yeah, it's always good when you have roommates that are doing as well as you, if not better, because you can feed off of each other. Good ball speed there.
That's as good a ball as she's thrown in two matches right there, and she needs it because Clara Guerrero is working on three straight. The U.S. Open Bowling Tournament will take place at the South Point Bowling Plaza in Las Vegas, Nevada, November 3 through 9. For more information on how to take part in one of bowling's most prestigious events, visit bowl.com/US Open. Right now, Josie's working at a 259 max.
Very interesting how Clara spends a lot of time with that waggle. Mm-hmm. Right here, she spends a lot of time getting that hand in the ball just the right way for the good feel.
Stop. Hi.
Well, she probably set three or four splits past through her eyes before she was left with that nine pin.
She will use her plastic ball or polyester ball to shoot at this. Very deliberate on her spares as well. Almost the same amount of deliberance as her strike ball.
And she removes that wrist guard as well for this.
It allows for the fingers to flex more, which cuts the ball roll down. She wears an extended finger glove, which makes the finger stop and gives you a lot stronger roll. All the gadgets.
There's Josh Kubiak, Clara's husband. He looks more nervous than she is right now.
It's always tougher to be back there. All the way from Austin, Texas, or thereabouts.
Not a bad place to be.
Come on.
And it did.
So she kind of slips on this shot. If you watch her, and she has a little bit of wiggle in her feet, but because her head is so steady, she was able to kind of keep herself up, and the body angle that she has allows her to keep her balance as well.
Push. Yes.
Wow, boy, Josie Earnest is really on her game at the moment. Clara Guerrero is bowling tremendously at a 237 pace, and it may not be enough.
I bet Josie's coaches, Kim Terrell Kearney and Rod Ross, are very pleased to be watching her on TV today.
Wow. But I don't know if I've ever seen any bowler make it look any easier than Kim.
Not Kim Adler. Kim
Terrell Kern. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And if it was
sometimes
you, I would
I didn't
have said
make it
you.
Look that easy.
No, yes. But she does.
Okay.
She really does. Josie again, and she broke up troubles, left with a four pin. That one got a little bit away up the middle.
And I think the lanes are starting to hook a little bit in that middle part again. That was a decent shot with good speed, and they're just starting to hook a little bit. It's so interesting to watch balls go down the lane on TV lights and how much it changes the oil and moves everything around.
I've had that conversation before with a few people about the lighting and the effect it has here. Or on lanes, I should say, not just here, but everywhere. I want to let you know that any player who converts a 7-10 split on our CBS Sports Network Finals will receive a $100,000 bonus courtesy of Ultimate Bowling Products.
That would be a nice payday.
You'd have earned it, that's for sure. Mm. So now look at what our maximums can be. Only one pin separating the two.
Just about the scoring pace we've had all week.
Yeah. Double it up in the ninth.
Really aggressive shot there from Clara. When she throws it aggressively, you can hear that glove go click, click with the quiet. And it just mixes those pins up to the five and to the seven.
Shannon O'Keefe waits the winner for the championship. The PWA Rochester Open. Now this lane has been a second home for Clara. Strikes every time.
I don't want to say it.
As I can handle that. As a player, you don't want to think that way. Got there, though, and she's left with a 6-10.
I don't think she liked that off of her hand. I mean, it looks pretty good, but her feet might get a little fast. Definitely left. That is not the direction you want to miss. Her thumb in twice, puts her thumbs in, and then rechecks it for the spare.
A lot of idiosyncrasies going on there. No trouble.
She's got to fill these frames, put some pressure on Josie.
Come on.
So she's hoping for a 215.
Good shot there.
And a quiet 10 pin for a 214 for Clara Guerrero.
That was a good finish for her. Much better shot of her hand, a little different. It's amazing, just a little difference in like a half mile an hour in speed. You can see it in the ball reaction.
Josie Earnest, there you go, 9 pins to win. Now when you know that, and I know she knows it, the process, you don't want to all of a sudden become defensive, I'm guessing.
No, you're not even really. If you're thinking about it, you're in trouble.
Good shot.
Pretty good shot.
How about 10 to win? Josie Earnest has moved into the finals to take on Shannon O'Keefe as she inches closer to her first PWBA title. And a spot in the Smithfield PWBA Tour Championship. Now, Brianna Cote won the PWBA Lexington Open to become a first-time winner on the tour. And you're looking at perhaps another first-time winner. But to do so, She's going to have to defeat Shannon O'Keefe, who's made getting on television in the summer. She's a steady show, unlike some of the ones that show up and get canceled after 2 weeks. You can turn on your TV and you'll see Shannon O'Keefe a lot. And you're going to see her against that woman right there, Josie Earnest. Anchor down so far for Josie, the Commodore assistant coach, against the McHenry head women's coach coming up. Earnest has moved on to the championship. Take on Shannon O'Keefe for the solid performance against Clara Guerrero, 238-214. Well, in this week's USBC Bowling Academy tip, and we were just talking about her, Kim Terrell Kearney and Rod Ross will tell us why the consistency of your swing and the release point is so important to a well-rounded game.
One of the things that we see a lot of times here at the ITRC is the inconsistency of students' swings and their arm swings, and we really can see how they get into the top of the backswing, and it's not usually in a good place.
Right, and that's really where we do. We see inaccuracies at the arrow and some down at the break point, mostly because there's just an, you know, from shot to shot, their swing's coming from a different angle.
And they're sliding in the same place, they're laying the ball down in the same place, but it's coming from a different angle at the top of the backswing down through the shot, through their finish position towards the arrow, and they can see four or five boards plus difference down at the break point.
Right, so how you get it into the swing is most important, and then at the very same time, how it comes down, that we're not rerouting it, because that's just very difficult to control from shot to shot.
So we really look at two stages. One, getting into the backswing or to the top of the swing. And the next stage, how it comes out of the top of the swing into the release. And we just don't want to see a redirecting of the swing coming down to the release. You'll see some of them that if the ball is on the inside or outside of the head, they have to change the direction of that ball in the downswing, which gives them a very small release window. If you miss it a little bit, if it's behind their head, they miss a little bit, the ball goes out to the right. If they hold on to it a little bit longer, it goes actually left. So you have to release it at just the perfect time. If we can get it in line at the top of the head and it just drops down, all of a sudden that release window becomes very wide.
When we're coaching here at the ITRC, a lot of times when I'm looking at the video and we see players who have inconsistent launch angles, the first thing that I'm going to look for is what's going on at the start. Is there an inconsistency with the direction of their push away? Which in the end is going to be an inconsistency of where they are at the top of the swing. Sometimes it's inside of their head, sometimes it's outside of their head. And ideally we want to be just directly in line with the head when the ball's at the top of the swing.
Yeah, because you'll get it up to inside their head or outside their head. They have to redirect. So again, that release window is so small that you have to be perfect to be able to keep the ball on line. And we see that quite a bit. The elite players, you can see at the top of the backswing, it's in line with their head. You know exactly where that ball's going. There's no redirection at all on that downswing to the release.
The USBC Bowling Academy provides hundreds of hours of high-quality instructional videos for bowlers of all skill levels. Learn from Team USA and USBC certified gold coaches, as well as other top pros and instructors. Visit usbcbowlingacademy.com today for more information. Shannon O'Keefe, Josie Earnest, college coaches, great bowlers, champions coming up for the title. So here we go. It's Anchor Down versus the Bearcats of McHenry, otherwise known as Shannon O'Keefe, the head coach for the McHenry women, and Josie Earnest, an assistant coach for the Vanderbilt women, and they're ready to go. And at stake, a lot of points, $10,000, and for Josie Earnest, an automatic berth into the Smithfield PWBA Tour Championship here at the PWBA Rochester Open. And on this right lane that Josie Earnest will be getting to, she has 10 strikes. On the left lane, where she's starting, she has 4. She goes a little wide and knocked a sleeper out.
So that was interesting strategy for Shannon. Kind of a missed opportunity there to have her finish on her harder lane. But Shannon has reasons for everything. She's very calculated. So it was probably more offensive than defensive.
Sit.
Easy spare there. I hate to say easy. Nothing's easy, but nice sigh of relief to get that first one out of the way.
Yeah, a little smile. A little okay. Fine. Now we'll take a look at Shannon O'Keefe. She's had another TV appearance for Shannon O'Keefe. PWBA Lexington Open. She was on that show. Won a rather dramatic game against Shannon Pluhowski with a one-ball roll-off, but did not win the title. Brianna Cote did that.
Now she's managed to pick a ball that matches her outfit, which is also McKendree, and it's a sea of purple in the audience today.
Yeah, she's got a lot of Bearcats and McKendree t-shirts. That college program was already good, and then the O'Keefe family got there, and that's kicking it up another notch.
Yeah, you could just kind of pan around and see all that purple is all the show.
Yeah, a little Vanderbilt in there, too,
yeah,
mixed
bit.
In. I saw some Vanderbilt gear as folks were walking in today.
Now, Shannon, the furthest left Shannon got in this tournament during qualifying was the third arrow and going out to the second arrow, and she's about there right now. But it's definitely playing a lot differently than it did during the week.
3-6-10 on that one for Shannon.
So on this shot, again, big difference between left and right lanes. Here she throws a decent shot, very accelerating through the swing as she traditionally does. She's trying to keep it two or three right of that last marker down the lane, and you can see that it just kind of went over the middle. So this is hopefully a good spare for her.
And it is. Now, this is the businesslike Shannon O'Keefe. This is not her normal personality by any means. But out there under the lights, you're not going to get a lot of smiling from Shannon. Anywhere else, absolutely.
Well, it's not always about smiling. It's business out there for
her. Yes, it is.
Now, she's from O'Fallon, but she grew up or she spent a lot of her time in Rochester.
Did Shannon. Josie is from Vandalia, Illinois.
Correct.
But now in Nashville. That's a big snappy turn.
Ooh, and she almost took that pin out with the four pin.
Yep.
We can watch that again carefully here. The ball really comes into the head pin high there. We get a little kiss from the four, and it's going to topple it. Oh, so close. Shooting her spares always from the fifth arrow or so. You see a lot of that from the ladies on tour now. It's closer to the fifth arrow. You see a lot of the players shooting their spares than the fourth arrow, like we did, say, I don't know, 30 years ago, back in the rock ages of my career.
Now, Josie's just 28, too. That's the other thing. Her best years are ahead of her, I think. And a victory here, and then a chance to go to that PWBA Tour Championship in Virginia, is really going to just not only boost her confidence and her profile, but just another step in her growth.
If anyone's Pokemon going, experience points, very important.
That time through the nose, and that left lane's been a little bit tricky. And so she is looking at a 3-6-10 now, as Shannon O'Keefe had to deal with earlier.
She's not trying to complicate the process of trying to figure out the lane. She's just trying to stay within herself, which she says is one of her strengths. She really tries to stay in her own game but be aggressive at the same time.
You don't get a bonus for making that one, but if you convert a 7-10 split on our CBS Sports Network finals, you'll receive a $100,000 bonus courtesy of Ultimate Bowling Products. Shannon O'Keefe, her fifth appearance this summer on television. And a couple of wins. Also won the Lucy. In fact, she's won the last two Lucys with Bill O'Neill. That's a crossover, and she is fortunate to have left just the three.
Don't see a lot of players missing the ball right today. Do you see a theme here?
Yeah, I do. You're right. So how do you avoid what just happened here?
Well, you have to create a little bit more angle through the front part of the lane, but not too much. It's a very delicate line. She might want to move like one board, but on the sport pattern, it's a lot of times the girls are just thinking, throw a better shot from the same place.
Watch live early round coverage of all PWBA events, plus live and on-demand coverage of all of the best professional bowling action on Extra Frame. Visit extraframe.tv for more information or to subscribe today. Oh, that was an interesting one. She's left with the 5-pin. It just slid a little bit off. And so we've seen it 1,000 times, Kim. Sometimes you go too far one way and you compensate and you overcorrect.
Yeah, and once again, everyone is trying, that left lane is everyone's problem lane. And she's spending a little time trying to, it's very delicate. You have to throw it perfectly within a half inch.
So both players making their spares so far, and that's what it's come down to. We've had just one strike. That was by O'Keefe on her first ball.
All the strikes are missing. Now, where'd they go? They were all in last game.
Josie Earnest certainly had. Playing Claire Guerrero bowled well. Just, it's tough to beat somebody who gets into the 230s.
Good shot off her hand there.
There you go,
10
straight.
Never doubt on that one.
Yep, absolutely. She didn't even have to talk to the ball. That was such a pretty shot.
She really drops that ball into her steps, which really keeps her swing very loose. To me, she doesn't look very excited getting up on this lane.
This is the trip to the dentist right now. Yep. Sometimes a trip to the dentist doesn't hurt, though, and it's a solid double for Josie Earnest. We talked a little bit about Brianna Cote, and there she is, the PWBA Lexington Open champion. So she will be in that group of 16, that very select group for the Smithfield PWBA Tour Championship in Virginia. We know Shannon O'Keefe is already there. Josie Earnest hasn't gotten the envelope yet. She'll get that invitation if she can win this match. And a ball change for Shannon.
She made eye contact with her husband slash coach, Brian O'Keefe. They gave some twin language hand signals, and before you know it, she's changing balls.
Before you know it, she gets her second strike of the match, and a powerful one at that.
We had a nice conversation the other day about getting into 2016 and what has made everything come together. And she says it was really the U.S. Open loss, the devastation of the loss last year to Liz Johnson, that really brought everything together this year, because it kind of refocused her, and she really wants this for her team, McKendree team.
Unfortunately, a 4-6-7. Well, look, if you lose a U.S. Open final, Liz Johnson, you're one of plenty of people who have done that now that Liz has 5 U.S. Open championships. But you're right, Shannon was devastated. She had a chance. She left an open in the 10th. A tough spare to make, but she's made them before. 1-2-4-10, and then Liz closed her out. And it was difficult. There's no question. How do you not feel badly about that? She'll take the punt. There's Brian O'Keefe. There'll be more communication. This time they can actually talk to each other, and they probably will during the break. Right now, Josie Earnest has the 20-pin lead. She'll lead off at the 6th when we return. So in 2015, Liz Johnson won the Player of the Year, and guess what? She's the front runner to do it again. Now, this is based on total points, and that's where Liz is right now on top. That U.S. Open Championship certainly helps. Danielle McEwen and Shannon Bluhowski, then Clara Guerrero in 4th, Rocio Restrepo in 5th, and Shannon O'Keefe in 6th. And Shannon will get a little boost from this event, win or lose.
It's all so close, and yet so far. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. Coming back from the break. Now, the last time Josie Earnest came back from break, she doubled. That is hard to do. It pushes, and she continues her post-break streak of strikes.
I was watching Shannon's expression just behind her as she got up on the approach, and Shannon is quite perplexed about this right lane now. But Josie, again, a lot of rotation, I just like to see her just throw it just a little harder, just to keep it in the same part of the lane.
Well, she's in position to really throw some shade at Shannon O'Keefe here with another strike.
The dogs on her shirt are barking.
Man, 10 straight back for Josie.
What a great shot out of Josie. Look at her. She's having fun.
Kind of smiling. Yeah, did I do that? Yeah, I did that.
She mentioned this to me. She wants to remember these little bits and pieces of every show and really get the experience out of it. So that's why she's kind of loosening up here. And she, yeah, there's some juice.
Yep. Shannon's on that lane. Oh, and she got a tap on the 10. Still kicking. There's no way she's not going to go down without a big fight.
There was a little debate happening between her people and her on the break about ball reaction, and she kind of liked it. You know, it still comes down to what the player feels is the best.
Yeah, who
because
gets
you
got to
be the one
vote.
throw the ball.
Right.
And be confident in it.
Well, I did hear a little bit of that conversation. Three words I did were, I'm not happy.
Yeah. Great shot there. Well,
beautiful. So she answers back, and that's all she could do if she wanted to stay in this match.
That should make her a little happier.
Except when she looks up and sees she's still down 30 to somebody who's nailed four straight strikes.
Well, she's not out of time yet.
Nope.
We've got 10 frames here. Josie taking quite a bit of time there. Oh, great shot off her hand.
Look out, Brooklyn.
Oh, and it just hooked in that middle part right around the 12 board. Let's take a look at that. That was unexpected. I don't believe that actually happened, but she get the ball into her swing pretty good. Turn the ball a little earlier. That's what made the ball roll a little soon. And she knew that. You could tell she's immediately mental process trying to regroup that and get the feel of the swing and way her hand should go.
Oh. Ooh, that sounded funky. She got it, though.
We're bowling. We're not basketball.
Yeah, that.
Oops.
That's a shot here on a Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock at your local bowling establishment. Let's listen into that little double bouncer here if we can.
You might hear her go, oof. Oh. But it was headed the right way, so fortunately it was covered.
So her lead trimmed to 28, and we get to the foundation.
She threw a really good shot on this lane last time. See if she can do it again.
Gotta hurry. She did throw a pretty good shot and is left with a 10 pin.
It was a little tentative at the bottom, like she tried to help it a little extra. You can tell by her deep breaths that there was probably a breathing issue in the middle of her approach that maybe caused that to happen. See, she's already taking some quicker breaths, which really you can see that really affects the quality of the shot.
She's so close. Now we talk about so close and so far.
Right.
That trophy has to feel like it's 1,000 miles away right now. But she's got to take care of the simple things, so it's not so simple, like cleaning up a 10 pin.
And no double bounce.
She did that very well. Now she's going to have to watch and see what happens here with Shannon O'Keefe. Max for Josie is at 233. Shannon's max is at 226. Let's see if Shannon's going to force Josie Earnest to have a big 10th frame.
Real aggressive shot there.
Wide. She needs a message, and she's not going to get it. So she's going to have to come up with a mini miracle on this one.
I think she just got this a little further right with the speed. And that ball just doesn't want to make the turn quite as easily as it does on the left lane.
Gotta go
Give
for
it. A
it.
Run here.
Well, you think Josie Earnest is having a hard time breathing now, but before, she is so close. She's trying not to celebrate.
Very disappointed, Shannon.
Well, you know what? She can celebrate. She won. Josie Earnest is a first-time champion. There's nothing that can happen here that Shannon O'Keefe can do. She can strike out for a 192, but Josie's already sitting at 193.
What a way to win your first title. She's still trying to do the math in her head, I think.
No more thinking is required, Josie. So look at who she had to beat. She had to beat a Hall of Famer, Carolyn Doran Ballard. She did that. She beat Clara Guerrero, an international star, an accomplished talent, and she's beaten Shannon O'Keefe, who's had this fantastic 2016 season and will certainly be part of the BWBA championship. And now Josie Earnest is invited.
The Titan Slayer, I will call her from now on.
Well, she was today. Not that she's not a player now. I think it's sinking in now. Not that she is not an accomplished player in her own right, but this might be the biggest day of Josie Earnest's professional career.
And what a way to go up. She gets to go up in a 10th frame and celebrate the whole 10th frame.
Yep. This will be a fun one to throw for Josie. So another first-time champion this summer. We have a first-time champion here, Brianna Cote, who won the PWBA Lexington Open, and now we're going to have another first-time champion right here. Well, that's how you do it.
Yeah. What a way to end it.
Good for her.
Now she can relax. She's double-checking the score. She's triple-checking the score, making sure she's in the right building in the right place. Wait a minute, am I really a champion?
Yeah, she's looked at that big board. There's a board the players can see that is off of camera range, and it gives them an opportunity. It's a huge, it's almost like a giant film screen from elementary school type thing. And she double, triple checked that, as Kim said, a couple times. She's going to punch out a champ.
And she's looking off to the side to see if her banner is ready.
That's
if it's
right.
been prepared and already placed up there for her.
You get a banner when you win. Remember at the U.S. Women's Open a while back, Niu Wei Fen, I asked her, what would it mean to win? She says, I want a banner. There you go.
There
Josie
is.
Earnest gets a banner, a $10,000 check, her first championship. And a berth in the Smithfield PWPA Tour Championship. And this is also our Smithfield moment of the match. Josie Earnest taking the trophy back to Nashville. Anchor down. Your champion is Josie Earnest, who defeated three sterling stars of the PWBA to pick up title number one of what we hope will be many.
The PWBA Rochester Open on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Smithfield. Flavor hails from Smithfield. Get inspired at smithfield.com today. By Pepsi, the official soft drink of the PWBA Tour. And by Kegel, your lanes, our passion.
So Josie Earnest went all the way up the stepladder, defeating Carolyn Doran Ballard, then Clara Guerrero on a strike fest, and then Shannon O'Keefe with a pretty clean game for Josie. 229, look at how she bowled as she got better all the time, and when she had to have it, she had it, and earning her first win on the PWBA Tour. Mike Sleds, the Director of League Development for Bullmore AMF, will present the trophy to our champion, Josie Earnest. And Josie is standing by with Kim Adler. Kim?
So Josie, wonderful night. Great bowling. How does it feel to be a first-time champion?
It's a pretty indescribable feeling. I've had the opportunity to win and compete in a lot of different things, but this one pretty much tops them all.
Well, congratulations to you. Great tournament, and we'll see you in the Players' Championship.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
It's more than cool. The great bowling by Josie Earnest is cool enough to earn herself that nice trophy, a beautiful check, and the berth in the Smithfield PWBA Tour Championship. She's one of only 16 who will be at that event. Congratulations, Josie. A presentation of CBS